Y'all, I have been wanting to speak on this, but I was putting it off. But I'm 15 minutes early to work, so I'm going to speak on it today. The trans rights movement, lack of progress and intolerance being shoved on black women. Black women get blamed for a whole lot of stuff wrong. And it's really disgusting. We have some of the least rights in the country, but we are getting blamed for things we have no control over. So what I'm specifically referring to, and I've been wanting to talk about it, and I put it off. I made a video about this, but then I erased it because I don't want the negative comments associated with it. But I don't care. You know, once your coworker subscribes to your page and is in your business, you don't really care anymore. You're just like, forget it. Now, it was always related to my job and not wanting a coworker to find my page and them seeing. I'll never be able to hide my personal life from any coworkers on my little, no matter how private I make my YouTube, because every job I've ever had, somehow people find it. I'm not that interesting, but I guess maybe I am a little interesting. But anyway, this is an older story, but I never said anything about it. Somewhere during the Black Lives Matter movement, and when all of a sudden, within a week of Black Lives Mattering, trans lives started mattering. And not that they don't, but can we get some black lives to matter first before we scooch that in? But whatever, that's fine. Somewhere between that and even before that, it was this narrative being spun. It's kind of like talked about, sort of, kind of. It's this narrative being spun that men who are down low in trade and undercover are killing trans women partially, not all the 100%, but partially because black women are not accepting of trans people. I'm looking around because I'm trying to find where the fuck you made that leap. That is a leap and a jump through the center of time. How we have now gotten blamed indirectly for black men killing trans people. And let's not even get started again. Black men are not the only people killing trans people. White men are killing trans people. Hispanic men are killing trans people. For some bizarre reason, it gets reported super big overtime when it's a black dude that does it. That's another story in itself. Let's focus on that. But black women, we can't even get black men to act right. So how on earth are we controlling the narrative on whether or not black people or whether or not trans people are being killed because of how we are not accepting of it? Within our own relationships with black men, which I date interracially, I don't date black men, but I've heard stories and I've talked to people. But from other black women's stories, from their own troubles and issues with black men, how are they influencing black men's view on trans people when we can't even get, when black women can't even get their own relationships on point and so many issues with black men? We don't have time to sit around and try to destroy the way black men view trans women. We're struggling. Other black women are struggling with their own relationships with black men. To have that put on us, everything is put on black women. Black men being losers gets put on black women. Black women being told they don't know how to, what do you call it? Consent or not consent, you know, like be ladylike and let the man be a man. Well, when I have a fucking degree or a really great job and I work my ass off and you don't think you have to work as hard as I do, I'm not going to treat you like the man because you are actually a byproduct. You are the woman. Not for real, but kind of. So I'm not going to mindlessly treat you. But that's another topic. Let me get back on topic. That's another video. I think it's so pathetic for people in the trans community to be putting this crap on us. It's not black women's job to fix this, to make it Oh, I'm going to say it. It's not black women's job to fix the comfort level for black men to make it easier for trans women to have sexual access to black men. That's not our job to make black men more comfortable so that they can have sex with more trans women and openly have sex with trans women. That's the whole goal is, I'm going to say it, not even really killing. Well, of course, that's horrible. Of course, duh. But it's like, it's the responsibility is being put on us so that more trans women can have more free and open access to black men. So we're supposed to try to help it become more comfortable so that we can have even less black men available. Okay. Well, sorry. We got to fix our own stuff and our own issues. And another thing. Where is the LGBTQI community? My coworker, he's so cute. Where is the LGBTQI community in this? Why aren't the LGBT? You know, you're part of the community. Why isn't the LGBTQI community more active in doing this, in taking on this role? Why does it fall on black women who are already struggling with our own, oh my God, it's hot in this car. With our own, it didn't work, with our own crippling issues. Why can't the LGBT, Lord, LGBTQI community come in, stop, and be more supportive? Hold on, my car's acting stupid. In that area. You know why? I'm about to say something, an ugly truth. Another thing people don't talk about. The majority of gay people I know don't even fool with the trans community. I support the trans community. I don't have any issue with the trans community. I think you have a desire. If you decide that you are a woman, you are a woman. If you decide, if you were biologically born a man, and you decide to be a woman, well, then you should be seen as a woman. You have a right to that. But the average gay person I've spoken to, friends, in random conversations, don't even really openly support the trans community. But black women are supposed to come put a cape on when your own community, in secret, because this is not an open thing, support the trans community. It's just like the black community, like black civil rights leaders, well-off established black civil rights leaders secretly are disgusted and detest really hood ghetto people. They would never say that in public. They pretend like they want to hold the whole community to be okay, but they're really disgusted by really, really ghetto people because they view them as the lowest, like the trash. But in the black community, nobody would ever say that out loud, especially a black activist. So that's what I'm comparing it to as far as the LGBTQI community in relation to trans rights. Just like it's quite a few racist people in the LGBT community who don't fool with black people. They just are for gay rights. They could care less about black rights. I've heard of similar stories about trans rights. And it's like the people within your own community behind the scenes don't even give you the support. Why is it being put on us to fix it? How the hell are we supposed to? Black men are men within their own right. And then let's not just address black men, the white men, the Hispanic men. Why are we being centered? Why isn't this being addressed with the other men of other races too? Black women are not the only ones this so-called responsibility to fix this issue needs to be placed on. Put it on everybody. I'm just tired of the narrative, once again, of black women being told we need to fix something. We didn't create it. Black men, make black men accountable for their own selves. Stop sleeping with them in private. They know you're trans. It's not that confusing. A few people it's confusing. But stop allowing them to lay with you and abuse you and you keep laying with them. Make them accept you. We can't fix that. But anyway, I'm going in circles now. I'll come back to that issue when I get to do a little bit more research. Bye.